Good afternoon, everyone. Today, we're going to present our research about floating maxim in Encanto movie. We are from Group T, and my name is Sarani.
My name is Nadira.
And my name is Nilamder.
Okay, so in this research, we found four floating maxim category, namely floating maxim of quantity, quality, relation, and manner, were found in many conversations in the Encanto movie. The following are the findings for floating maxim in the Encanto movie. Encanto is a 2021 American animated musical movie that was produced by Walt Disney Animation Studio and was directed by Jared Bass and Byron Howard. Encanto tells a story about Colombian teenage girl named Mirabel, who has to face the frustration of being the only member of her family without magical powers. So the first is floating maxim of quantity. In this conversation between Abuela Alma and Dolores. First, Abuela Alma, first announcement, I spoken to the Guzman about Mariana's proposal to Isabella. Dolores, do we have a date? And Dolores said, tonight, he wants five babies. In the bold, he wants five babies. The sentence are categorized as floating maxim of quantity because Dolores have gave extra information to respond to the conversation. And the second is the conversation between Abuela Alma and Peppa. Abuela said, Peppa, calm down. And Peppa respond to, I'm doing my best. You are lucky it is not a hurricane. The sentence are categories as floating the maximum of quantity because Peppa gave extra information to respond to the conversation.
So the next one is floating maxim of quality. We found floating maxim of quality in this conversation between Mirabel and Luisa. Mirabel, you got to tell me about the magic. What's going on? What are you hiding? Luisa, nothing, just got a lot of course. So maybe you should just go home. Mirabel, Dolores said your eye was twitching and it never twitched. Something is making you nervous. Just tell me what it is. Luisa, there's nothing to tell. Mirabel, you are obviously worried about something. If you know something's wrong with the magic and you didn't, and Luisa answered with nothing's wrong. In the dialogue above, Mirabel was asking Luisa about the magic because Dolores said something is bothering Luisa. But when Mirabel confronted her, she said nothing is bothering her, and this is obviously a lie because Dolores said the otherwise. In this case, Luisa used floating maxim of quality because she lied to Mirabel by giving her false information. She avoided her question by not telling her the truth. Another example is shown in the conversation between Mirabel and Bruno. Mirabel, have you been in here patching the cracks? And Bruno answered, oh, that? No. I'm too scared to get near those things. All the patching is done by Hernando. Mirabel, who is Hernando? Bruno, Hernando is scared of nothing. In the dialogue above, Mirabel was asking Bruno about the cracks in the house. He lied by saying Hernando was the one who has been patching the cracks. This is untrue because Bruno himself patched the crack. Thus, Bruno used floating maxim of quality because he lied to Mirabel.
So the next one is the floating maxim of relation found in Encanto movie. The first conversation is dialogue between the kids and Mirabel. Just tell us what everyone can do. And Mirabel answered, and that's why coffee is for grown-ups. So in this dialogue, the kids in town were asking Mirabel what her family members' powers are, especially Mirabel's power. They demanded a clear answer from Mirabel, but Mirabel kept on dodging the questions by giving unrelated answers. The type of floating maxim that is used by Mirabel is floating maxim relation because she didn't give a response relevant to the topic which is being discussed when she actually can. And Mirabel refused to answer the question with a relevant and clear answer because in reality, unlike her family, she doesn't have any power. And the next example is the conversation between Mirabel and Bruno. Why did you take the vision? And Bruno answered, knock, 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 knock on wood. So in the dialogue above, Mirabel was asking Bruno about the vision, but instead of giving a relevant and clear answer, he gave her a nonsense response. This answer is not relevant to the topic being discussed. Thus, Bruno used floating maxim relation to avoid Mirabel's question. And the last one is floating maxim of manner. There are also two conversations. The first one is the conversation between Mirabel and Theo Bruno. Our family needs help and you need to get out of here. And Bruno just answered, meh. The conversation both happened when Mirabel was still trying to convince Theo Bruno to see more about vision. Theo Bruno refused to have another vision, citing the need for a large open area. And Antonio appeared unexpectedly and informed them that they could use his room. Mirabel then said to Theo Bruno as described in the conversation above. Theo Bruno's response was not clearly expressed. It demonstrated that he used obscurity of expression and created ambiguity. So Bruno's response appears to be yes. And as a result, he broke the manners rule. And the last one is the conversation between Theo Bruno and Abuela Alma. She didn't do this. She didn't do this. I gave her a vision. It was me. I was like, go. And she was like, you only want to help. I don't care what you think of me, but if you are too stubborn to do. And Abuela Alma answered, Brunito, with embraces and kissed him. And Tio Bruno said, I feel like I missed something important. So this is the end of our presentation. Thank you for your attention. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.